Hey there, Teresa here with Web Designs by Teresa, bringing you another little technical tidbit to help you with your success and your online presence. And today I want to talk to you about the shiny object syndrome and recovering from that shiny object syndrome. And I'm talking, of course, specifically about all of the cool tech out there. Now, there is always some new, cool, amazing technical app, tool, device, thing that you can get that is supposed to really help make your life, your business, your everything better. Tools that are out there to help you increase your visibility, to simplify your life, to bring you more customers, and they all promise lots of big results. The trouble with that is that you can't have everything because they don't always work well together. And you're only going to get those big results when your commitment to that tech tool is 100% to use it for your advantage. And so here is my suggestion when it comes to finding the cool new tech out there before you put your card information online and buy that tip. I want you to ask yourself these three key questions. First of all, does this fit into my budget? Hands down, if this new tech tool, this new amazing thing does not fit in your budget, it's out. Get it out there. We have to stop operating from a place of scarcity and stop buying things that we can't afford just to make our business better. Create a budget that you can follow and look for the tools that fit in that budget, because you're going to be a lot less stressed and a lot more successful when that happens, and you can grow your business without spending thousands and thousands of dollars on all of the cool new tech. The next question that I'm going to have you ask yourself is, can I implement this tool, this tech, whatever it is, right away? If you can't implement it right away, don't pay for it right away. Put it on your future calendar, look for implementing it in the next few months, and then go buy it now. It doesn't matter if it's on sale today, paying for it for 6 months when you're not using it doesn't save you a dime. It'll be on sale again in the future. So don't feel rushed to buy it unless you're ready to implement it. And the last question that I want you to ask yourself is, does this add value to my business? Does it add value to the client experience? And is it a value that's worth paying for? You want to make sure that you have a hard yes on that, because if it's not adding value, then it's adding to your to-do list and it's adding to your financial burdens, and that's not necessarily going to promote your business in the right way. Now, I know that a lot of you already have some cool shiny tools out there that you purchased that you may not be using. So here's what I want you to do just to make sure that you are getting the most for your tech and that you are giving your business your all in the best possible way. Take a look at your financial statements, and you may need to go back up to a year sometimes if you have those yearly subscriptions, but take a look and see what subscriptions am I paying for. And do a quick inventory of those subscriptions and ask yourself, am I using this tool? If you're not, get rid of it. There's no reason to be paying for something if you're not going to use it. Then I want you to ask yourself, does it add value to my business and my clients? Again, if it's not adding value, get rid of it. And finally, ask yourself, does this really fit into my budget? Can I operate on something else that's less money? There's always new tech coming out here, and if it's something that is easy to implement and saves you money, then it may be worth looking into. So those are my tech tips for today. Thank you guys so much for joining me. I hope you have found value in this video, and I look forward to connecting with you guys in future videos coming up here throughout the month. Have a great day. Bye.